3 weeks in advance. Oh yeah, booyah. So, what is up everyone? Fox here. Yeah, if you remember last week at the end of the episode, I mentioned that I was sort of gonna see if I could sort of just push off recording for a little while rather than going 3 weeks in advance, but I'm sorry, I couldn't hold myself back. I am recording this 3 weeks in advance, and I don't care. So, I went back to the Cyclops, and I went ahead and swapped some things out. So I dropped one oxygen tank. I also dropped the Sea Glide, because it was taking up a lot of space. And I made a flashlight. I made a flashlight, because we don't have the Sea Glide. And then I have our welder with us. So, actually, I probably should have... Wait, no, that's not my welder. Two. Yeah. So, I probably should have brought some batteries with me. Oh, this reduces radiation? 9 radiation leaks remaining. Oh, now you see, that is cool. That is cool. Right. Crap. 3. All right, you know what? You just stay over there. Leave me be. Don't bother me. Come on. 8. Oh, come on. 7 radiation. So I'm assuming that this is reducing the amount of radiation that is getting thrusted into this room, or just really out into the atmosphere in general, because I think it's safe to say that this is the engine room, and you know, this is like a nuclear drive, fusion drive. I am not an engineer, so I wouldn't know anything. I probably should have made me a first aid kit, huh? Yeah, probably should have made me a first aid kit. Alright. And whabam. Alright. I have no clue if that actually did anything. I'm hoping it did. Oh, come on. 4. And after this, it's going to be 3. Oh, come on. There we go. Ooh. Yeah, but where? Where? Oh, there's a breach. Okay, let's go ahead. Alright. Yes. Go down here. Repair. Come on. After this, there's only 2 more. Alright. Where? Okay, here's another one. Oh my gosh. I am so happy that nothing is attacking me. They know who's boss. They know who's boss. Oh, they are not happy.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I don't think so. Okay. And dive back down. So where is the final thing that I gotta repair? Where is it? I don't see it anywhere. Okay. I don't know where it is. Unless it's like up here. Unless it's like up here. Is it up here? I'm assuming. I don't know. But you know what? We got our radiation suit. There's only one remaining radioactive leak. So I'm going to say that we're fine and that we can keep exploring. Actually, no, it's probably best if I do find that that last leak, wherever it is. Like, I don't know where it could be, because I pretty much explored everywhere. Yeah, no, it's not. So it has to be somewhere here. It has to be somewhere here. The only problem is... Oh, wait. Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is. Stop throwing my mouse all around. There we go. Oh, that didn't hurt anyone. Okay, okay, okay. Oh, come on, come on. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Drive core breach here. Radiation dissipation in 3 days. Try download attempt. High energy particle containment field restored. Oh, that decontamination sequence initiated. That means I only need my radioactive
radiation levels are estimated to return to safe levels in T minus 3 days, 10 hours.
All right, so in 3 days I don't need my radiation suit anymore. Meaning I can swap it for a better thing. Alright, that is cool. How much of this can I repair? How much of this can I explore, actually, is what I want to know. Oh, this is... Assessing internal damage pattern inconsistent with internal malfunction or a black box device not found. Alright, so we have to find the ship were rendered in half during the detonation. So, oh, this is so cool. Alright, what is over here? What is over here? What are you? Oh, what the hell are you? Yeah, yeah, die. Okay, you're dead? Oh, what the hell was that thing? Disinfected water. Cool, I will drink that. Hey there. You're also... Oh! Oh, this is bad. Oh, that thing sent me flying. Oh, this is bad. Oh, this is bad. This could not be... Actually, I probably shouldn't say that this couldn't be any more worse, because it could definitely be a lot worse. Why am I so slow? Why am I so slow? Is it because... Okay, is it because I had to drop that? Okay, yeah. Yeah, it looks like I increased my speed. Let's go ahead and let's see what's in you. Food? Maybe? Nope, just water. Water and batteries is all I've been able to find. Like, seriously? Alright. Need to get back in the ship. Need to get back in the ship. Can I please get back in the ship? I wonder if this is like the only entrance to the ship also. Like, I wonder if there's more entrances? Question mark? Question mark? I should probably actually bring some preserved food with me. So, grab a hoverfish. Actually, don't grab whatever you are. No, there's a lot of those things. I will just leave that be. Alright, so the sea moth is still in there. Ooh, roadkill. Thank you. Yep, that's right. Seafood roadkill.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Hey, how's it going? Let's go ahead and grab some salt, because the salt, I believe, will preserve the, my food. I'm assuming. So, food, cured food, cured pepper. Yeah, it says preserved in salt. So, I'm assuming they're all preserved. So, let's just go for it. Let's just go for it. Alright, go you. Close you behind me. And, oh boy, we need to get all the way back in the ship. Because we got blown to hell by whatever the hell those things were. I mean, seriously, those kicked our butt. Those kicked our butt so hard. Alright. So let's go ahead and make our way shimmy sham all the way up in here. All the way up in here. Where soon, very soon, I mean, very soon for you guys, and probably very soon for me, because it'll probably happen, and we'll be gone. And that way I can make myself a reinforced suit for some nice armor plating. We can actually do whatnot. Awesome. Let's try this again. No. Where are they? Come on. Where are you at? Where are you at? Where are you at? Where are you at? I wish I could, like, pick you up, but I can't. Okay, you know what? No, let's not risk it. Let's not risk it. If I had my sea glide on me, I would say go for it. But we don't have our sea glide. So, let's not. I can't go through there. So, exactly how much of this is even explorable then? That's what I want to know. Nighttime approaches. You know, like, when and how do I use my, Oh, wait, no, this isn't my, Like, yeah, when and how do I use my thing? Oh my gosh. This is not cool. Because I don't have a bench or anything. And if I go in that water at nighttime, I am so boned. I'm going to be bone-a-roned so hard. I'm assuming there has to be multiple entrances to the Aurora. There has to be multiple entrances. Can I... Like, I don't know what to use the wire cutter on. I have absolutely no clue. You know what would be cool if they made it so that Because I don't necessarily... I know with a lot of these sort of games, there's no real end game. So I think it would be cool if, like, they made it so that, that the end game was to repair the Aurora, and then you get out of here. I mean, that would be pretty cool. That would be pretty cool. But I mean, currently I have absolutely no clue what the laser cutter cut things open. Alright, but I don't know what to cut open. That's the problem, unless I'm supposed to cut you open. Nope, that's not what I'm supposed to do. What about you? Nope, that's not... Oh, crap. I accidentally fired that. It is near impossible to see. Let's look at our data bank. Photo album. Log. Detection of extended debris field. Okay. Were rendered inhabitable during the detonation. Assessing internal damage. checking drive core damage against Aurora impact velocity. Calculation suggests was of insufficient magnitude to cause a core breach. Wait a minute. Checking drive core damage against Aurora impact velocity. Calculations suggest collision was of insufficient magnitude to cause a core... What caused the core breach, then? If colliding into the freaking planet didn't cause the core breach, what caused the core breach? Oh, that's not good. Detecting an extended debris field. Ooh. That's not good. That's not good. Mining vessel. Wait, Aurora mining vessel. Standard to berth emergency. I'm just going to sort of go through these things until daytime comes, because there's really no other thing that we can do. Limestone outcrops, already know about that. Technical. All environment protection suit. Onboard temperature, blah, blah, blah. Slimline build for maximum freedom of movement. CMOS stasis rifle. Alright, so what are these things? Structural analysis, scattered wreckage. Okay, so that's okay. But this standard two berth emergency life pod. That was me. So what's Aurora mining vessel overview? Oh, was this what this vessel? I thought this vessel was a terraforming vessel. Dark matter ion drive B8. Engineering section with A-grade facilities, including primary meteor cracker, manned robotic suit, and full scanner range. So these are things that are inside the ship that I can get, I'm assuming. Like, I don't know about the ion drive, but I'm assuming that there is an engineering section which I can get to, where I can get these things that are listed, and maybe even more. And then storage of mined resources. So there has to be a storage room somewhere in here. And then habitation section with C+ grade leisure facilities. Okay, so there should be a lot more to explore then. I just have to figure out how to get to those places. Just in case. My dog's barking. My dog is a barking. I apologize, everyone, but you know, that's the way dogs are. You know, they bark, they go woof woof, bow wow, yippity yap all day long. Oh, we are only in this small portion of the ship. Oh, there is still so much more to be explored. Alright. So, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go back to my Seamoth, and we are going to go exploring some more. We are going to explore some more before this episode is over, because we spent a lot of this episode just sort of sitting around and reading the logs, and as nice as that is to sort of get a feel as to the intensity of the situation, now that we kind of know what to expect for a little bit longer, like we know in 3 days I can swap out my radiation suit for something else. And then we also know that, well, that's kind of it. We know that the black box, we're supposed to find the black box. So there is a technical end game thing that we are supposed to do. We are supposed to find the black box. Oh, so that's how I repair my, All right. I mean, I guess I probably should have guessed that. I mean, it's kind of self-explanatory, like, you know, if the welder can repair habitat, then chances are it can probably repair a Seamoth. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and go in here.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
There we go. And we're going to go up. I do need to figure out how to restore energy, though. That is something that I still don't know how to do. Okay. Onwards and forward. We need to get to the other side of the ship. All right. Ooh, Nelly. What was that? Was that roadkill again? Damn fishies. Okay. I'm not seeing anything deadly. Let's see, we're gonna let go of the wheel and take a quick look. Okay, I don't see anything deadly. So let's continue. We should probably think about finding out how to upgrade my thing here. I'm not talking too much, I apologize. It's just I'm trying to concentrate, like, on are their voice, like, you know, the sounds. Like that. Okay. We're gonna take the Seamoth. Or not the Seamoth. We're gonna take the Cyclops in here. Mostly just because this makes me feel safer. It makes me feel safer, if only by a little bit. Oh, I don't like the noises that I am hearing. Oh, no. I actually need my Sea Glide this time. W- Will you stop that, please? Oh, Nelly. Watch. I'm gonna pop out and be like, big giant monster, dead. That'd be like the douchiest thing ever. No? Nothing like that? Cool. Alright. Oh, there's those things that are freaking a pain in my butt. So I still don't know where the, I still don't know where and how to use my cutter. I have absolutely no clue. Maybe on you? No. What are those noises? Oh, they can do more than just crawl. They can do more than just crawl. Get back in. They can jump. They can float. Oh! That is not advised. I know you say that, but I kinda wanna go in. I kinda really want. Why are these noises? Does it sound like they're getting louder? So, oh my gosh. And this is why the ocean. Oh, no, I want to get on. Okay, so, there, then, I'll go exploring over there, but exploration is not advised. So, to the other, actually, you know what, hold up. What's over here? What's over here? That's what I want to know. I want to actually get some exploration done. What about over here? No. Oh, I have a bad feeling as to what that was. You know, I haven't saved in a long time. We are going up. I'm saving. Come on. Scary. This is scary. What was that noise? That is not cool, man. I mean, it is cool, but at the same time, not cool, man. Oh, that's definitely getting louder. I can't see. Oh, will this be it? Will this be the end of me? Will this be the end of me? I have a feeling this might be the end of me. Maybe not. Maybe not. Let's go a little bit closer. Oh, what? What are those noises that I'm hearing? Those are not friendly noises. Those are not friendly noises. Okay. Okay, we're gonna do a quick save. That is not how you save. We're gonna do a quick save. And then we're gonna go for it. Oh, I'm so dead. Oh, I'm so dead. Oh, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? Okay, well, you know what? That's the... I was pointed... this way. Alright. Oh. Ooh. Okay, so can I get out then? Can I? I can't? Okay. Okay, that's... that's fine by me. I don't know where to go with this. Oh. Ooh, it's scary. Oh, it's so scary. Oh, and now it's dark. Oh, now it's really dark. All right. What are you? Oh, oh, is that okay? That's just my hand. That's just my hand. Nighttime approaches. That's not good. Oh, that's my welder. How do I... no, nothing. What are you? Okay. I honestly don't know. Oh, I'm just expecting to see, like, something humongous. Like, any moment now. It's not even funny. Oh, this was a bad idea. Oh, this was a bad idea. Okay, let's get back to my ship, and I'm just gonna end off this episode. Alright, come on. Yep, no, I can't take it anymore. I can't take it anymore. Ooh, I can't take it anymore. Okay, you know what? That's it. That is it. I need to work on some things. I think what we need to do is... actually, let's make a plasteel ingot right now. Just so we can get that condenser made. So, lithium. And then 10 titanium. So... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there we go. This will give us whatever this condenser thing is. Plasteel ingot. There we go. I don't know why it does that sometimes. But you, plasteel ingot. And pressure thingamabobber. pressure. I'm not too entirely sure what this does, so let's find out. Alright. Open you. I put the power efficiency upgrade in. So, what do you do? Rearranges the submarine hull's atomic structure to increase safe diving depth. Oh. Crush depth, now 400. Okay. Cool. So, can I, like... Can I, like, make more of those then? And then just, like, keep increasing the depth? That would be pretty cool. But you know what? I am all out of time for this episode. So, yeah, I don't know what to say. Dive reel. There is supposed to be something was supposed to be added, like floodlights was supposed to be added, but I don't know how and where. But I'll have to figure that out on my own time. So thank you all so much for watching. I am completely terrified right now. What was that? Oh, it needs to become daytime so I can get the hell out of here. But thank you all so much for watching. If you like this, go ahead and hit that like button. It is very much appreciated. Patreon down below as always. And I will be catching you guys later in hopefully a much more happier area than this scary, scary piece of metal. Bye-bye. Box out.